thanks to Linode for supporting this SciShow video. For all things Linode, you can go to linode.com/scishow. That link gives you a $100 60-day credit on a new Linode account. For those of you who are fans of diet soda, or fans of reading ingredients labels, like me, you may have noticed a warning that says contains phenylalanine on every can, bottle, or jug of diet soda you've ever had. Maybe you spent 2 seconds wondering about the dangers of this mysterious 5-syllable menace before shrugging and getting on with your refreshing beverage. And for 99.99% of you, that's fine. But if you happen to be one of the 1 in 10 to 15,000 people living with one rare genetic disease, that information was so important, it's worth baffling the rest of us over. Phenylalanine is an amino acid. That is a basic building block compound the body strings together to make proteins for a variety of uses. Phenylalanine is also a precursor in creating helpful substances like adrenaline and dopamine, which play a variety of information-carrying roles in our body. In short, phenylalanine is an essential ingredient in our body's kitchen. Though as vital as phenylalanine is to the body, it can't be produced by the body. Instead, we get our phenylalanine fix from external sources, mainly foods such as meat, poultry, fish, cottage cheese, lentils, peanuts, and sesame seeds. That makes it one of the so-called essential amino acids, meaning essential to ingest in our diets. The amino acid is also found in aspartame, an artificial sweetener used in many of the low-calorie, super-sweet foods and beverages on the market today. That includes many diet soda brands, sugar-free chewing gum, and so on. So if it's such a necessary and common component of our diet, it seems strange why we would need to be warned of its presence. Well, back to that 0.01% of folks we discussed earlier. Hi, by the way. Certain individuals simply can't digest phenylalanine or process it into all those helpful substances we discussed earlier. These people suffer from a genetic disorder known as phenylketonuria, or PKU. There are a few other similar conditions as well. People with PKU don't correctly produce an enzyme called phenylalanine hydroxylase, or PAH. That enzyme normally converts phenylalanine to another amino acid, tyrosine, for further use. Without functional PAH, high concentrations of phenylalanine can build up in the body. And phenylalanine, while necessary, is actually neurotoxic in high concentrations. Ask any toxicologist and they'll tell you, the dose makes the poison. It's the very definition of too much of a good thing. With too much phenylalanine swimming around, PKU can result in numerous negative health effects, including intellectual disability, seizures, tremors, and ataxia if left untreated. And unfortunately, treatment isn't as easy as just passing on the lentils. Individuals with PKU normally have to adhere to a low phenylalanine diet. This is as opposite to a high protein fad diet as you can possibly get. It means cutting out or reducing common foods like meat, fish, eggs, cheese, potatoes, corn, peas, and beans, and diet soda. Further, because completely eliminating protein from the diet would cause its own set of problems for the body, individuals with PKU often have to take poor-tasting and smelling formulas that contain other essential nutrients several times a day. And if you've had this experience, you may be screaming at the screen, yeah, it's really hard! If you are, say hi in the comments. With so many restrictions, it's not uncommon for individuals with PKU to struggle with maintaining such a rigid diet, which is why there's a lot of motivation to develop other treatment options. Over the past few decades, a breakthrough in PKU treatment has arisen from a surprising source: plants. In the mid-1950s, researchers were busy working to discover the origin of lignin, a chemical that gives plants rigidity. During their investigations, however, they found that the plants they were examining were using an enzyme called PAL, not PAH, to break down phenylalanine into smaller compounds. So throughout the next 6 decades, a hodgepodge of international researchers from various entities, private and public, gradually built upon that fortuitous finding. They were working to see whether PAL could do for humans what it does for plants. And it seems, for the most part, PAL is really good at breaking down phenylalanine into harmless byproducts the body can simply flush out. In 2018, PAL became available for daily use by injection to help manage phenylalanine levels. Plus, it potentially allows people with PKU to transition to a more typical diet, which means finally enjoying a delicious hot bowl of lentils. Every kid's dream. But PAL can have serious side effects for certain users, so researchers have been looking into other solutions. By 2019, multiple teams of scientists had launched various types of gene therapy experiments to treat this disease, using mouse models of PKU. That's right, a mouse who also can't drink diet soda. In one experiment, these brave furry participants received injections of genetically edited PAH-producing viruses into their livers to help produce the enzyme. Instead of making the mice sick, these so-called viral vectors would read out the gene for PAH. And the results were promising. The mice were able to sustain suitable phenylalanine blood levels for a period of 17 weeks. But if you've ever read Steinbeck, you'll know there's a big difference between mice and men. So more research is underway to determine the safety and efficacy of these kinds of therapies in humans. Lastly, if you're wondering if you could have PKU and need to mind those soda warnings, you probably already know if you have it. PKU tests have been routinely given to newborns in many countries since around the mid-1970s. And for individuals living with PKU, maintaining vigilance over how much phenylalanine is ingested is still a daily challenge, hence the explicit advertisement on diet soda cans. So now you know. The next time you see an unfamiliar warning on a product, even if it doesn't affect you, there is a reason, because it could potentially be life-saving to someone else. So carry on with your soda. Disclaimers for things like phenylalanine are the soda brand's version of open and honest discourse with you, the consumer. If you're looking for a product that goes beyond disclosure requirements and offers behind-the-scenes intel, you'll find it in Linode. Linode is a cloud computing company from Akamai that powers the internet worldwide through storage space, databases, analytics, and more. But they don't keep all of that power to themselves. Their platform's cloud manager source code is available online, so anyone can access it. They even take it one step further by explaining how the code works and how you can use it in video tutorials, written guides, and real-life customer support representatives available 365 days of the year. You can see all of Linode's tools and services by clicking the link in the description down below or heading to linode.com/scishow. That link gives you a $100 60-day credit on a new Linode account. Thanks to Linode for supporting this SciShow video, and thank you for watching.